much as you have. In fact, I have to tell you that my father, who is 84 years old now, was so excited that I was going to get to work with you tonight. He's like a legend. And my dad doesn't even do magic. My dad knows magic from the internet, and that's all. But of course, my dad is also excited anytime anybody older than he is still doing something that he loves. So you've had a great magic career. You've toured the world in air and sea. You've been an actor and a director in Hollywood. And you've done over 50 films. You've had your own circus. And at 100, almost 101, you're still active and performing. You write a column for The Linking Ring. I want you to think back. How did you get started in magic? How did you get started in magic?
Well, I saw Harry Thurston in Cincinnati. And then I bought a vanishing bowl of water. And then I entered an amateur contest. And they had singers and dancers and acrobats. And doggone it, I won the preferred prize. And then it went from then on and on and on. I have now played in almost every country in the world.
That's tremendous.
It's been very good to me. It bought me airplanes to fly, yachts to sail around the world. I've had lovely homes in California, a contract in the movies, and best of all is my wonderful little wife, Tammy. She came to see me Singapore. And we've been married now for over 50 years.
That's amazing. Now you've also, as I said, you've been in over 50 films. How do you as a magician become an actor in Hollywood? How did you become an actor in Hollywood, too?
How did what?
How did you become an actor in Hollywood?
Well, I gave a show in a theater in Hollywood, and it broke the record, the house record. Then I went to New York, and I played Lowe State Theater, and I broke the record there. And nobody's going to break it because the theater just was torn down.
That's great. What about the Jack Wynn story?
Oh, Jack Wynn used to do the torn restored magazine. Jack and his wife, Ann, were definitely the best magic act in vaudeville. Do you think that if they did vaudeville in Las Vegas, that the people would turn out to see it? If they had vaudeville shows instead of all magic shows?
I don't know. That's a good question.
Huh?
Probably so.
Well, I was thinking it might be a good idea if Siegfried would open the theater to vaudeville. And he could be the MC and introduce the act. And I think it might work.
We'll tell him this summer in Vegas.
The business in Las Vegas has gone very bad.
Now, I understand that your son Jimmy was the guest of honor at a very special dinner party. Your son Jimmy was a guest of honor at a very special dinner party. Jimmy, your son?
And what?
Jimmy, your son?
Jimmy the chimpanzee?
No, your son. No, your son. Your son. Your son Jimmy was the guest of honor at a dinner party. Just tell us about the chimpanzee. I think that's a better story. Do I have to get mad at Mark for this?
read this line.
I understand that your son, Jimmy, was the guest of honor at a very special dinner party. Can you tell us more about that?
My son.
Right.
When was this?
I don't know. I don't know, I understand he got drunk at a party in the... You guys are loving this, aren't you? Moving on!
What?
Okay, the chimpanzee.
Yeah.
It says his son.
No, it's Jimmy the chimpanzee.
Jensen, you are dead meat.
Tammy says you're talking about Jimmy the chimpanzee. Is that right?
Yes.
Well, good. Okay. Jimmy was a very intelligent little guy. He traveled around the world on board the yacht Magic Castle. And I taught him to fly an airplane.
You taught a chimpanzee to fly an airplane?
But
okay.
He didn't allow to land.
I can't even teach my wife to lock the car door.
Take off and let him hold the wheel. And if I pull it up into a stall, Jerry, you know what? If you pull back on the wheel, the airplane goes up like this. And he realized I was waiting to stall. He'd go, push your wheel down to bring the nose down. He wouldn't let me stall it. He didn't like it. He knew it was dangerous.
Okay. So you and Tammy have been together 51 years now. You've been married 51 years.
Over 50 years now.
How did she come to join the show? How did she come to join the show?
Well, I played Singapore, and I had a number of girls there, and she was one of the girls. She was under contract to a movie studio, and I talked her into going, joining our show, and took her on board the yacht, and we brought her to the States, and we got married. She's only been sorry once, ever since.
Only sorry once?
No, I said, Tammy's only been sorry once.
Okay.
Ever since.
When was she sorry? Okay. Okay, you've toured the world by air and by sea.
Right.
Tell us about some of the exciting things that have happened. I got here, plane crash. But that can be anything coming from Mark.
Later you asked me, I mean before earlier, you asked me about being attacked by the pirates.
Yeah, I love that story. Tell that.
Well, we were going along the coast of China, and my first mate came to me and he said, Captain, I see a strange looking ship coming toward us. He said, it might be two. So I took the binoculars and I could see that it was actually two instead of one. So when we were in Taiwan, the U.S. military gave us a lot of fireworks like they used to light up the airfields. But it was all fireworks, not any live ammunition. And so all around the taffrail of the yacht, I had men stationed with these fireworks. So, when we got within about 100 yards of this two ships, I yelled fire, and everybody let loose with the fireworks, and they pounded the decks of these two boats, and one went one way and one went the other, and we sailed straight between them. They kept on going, and so did we.
Gutsy. I After the whole Jenny escapade, I'm very happy to be at this next question. Are there any final words? Are there any final words you'd like to share about what's next for John and Tammy Calvert?
I hate to think about it. I tell you why. I am now over 100 years old. And I'll soon be 101. Now, what event do you think is going to happen?
Well, if I was 101, I think I would be sitting on a porch somewhere instead of doing magic shows. But I'm all for you. This is amazing.
I don't think I'm going to do it in price budget.
I don't know. I saw you I saw a couple of guys try to knock you over, and they couldn't. So that's it. Does anyone else have any questions in the room? Anybody else have a question you'd like to ask?
Gosh, what would it be?
You remember you remember a famous junior that died a few years ago, Blackstone Junior.
Oh yeah.
Well, we were at a convention up the convention that they have it up in
Abbott's.
At Abbott's, yeah.
Right.
The same year. And we were both going to work that night. And I said, Junior, we're both professionals. He said, right. I said, well, I don't think we should both do the same thing, do you? He said, of course not. And I said, now. So we know I don't get mixed up. I'm going to do the floating light bulb, the dancing handkerchief, and then I'm going to steal somebody's wallet. And I named everything that he did. He said, oh, you're pulling my leg. And then he told me, a few days later he called me, and he told me, he said, I'm going to the hospital tomorrow to have my gallbladder removed. So the next day I called his home, and his mother-in-law answered the phone, and I said, how's Junior? She said, well, they opened him up, and it was so infected, they sewed him back up again. And I said to Tammy, I'm afraid we've lost him. And 3 days later, he passed away. But I would like to give Gay Blackstone a great compliment for keeping his name alive.
Absolutely. So you were friends with Blackstone Jr. You saw Thurston. I can only imagine how that was. What other famous magicians have you seen? Did you ever get to see, say, Houdini or any of those guys? Those guys were gone by the time you were around, weren't they? 100? No, maybe not.
Well, I met most of the old timers and the ones in England as well. Have you ever been to the Magic Circle in London?
Yes.
Well, I just got a nice letter from them the other day. And it's certainly a great organization. One day in London, the Prince of Wales is married to the Queen, is this right? No.
Prince Charles.
Prince Charles.
He was learning to fly. and he told a flying story. He said an airplane was crossing the Atlantic, and on board was a German, a Frenchman, an Englishman.
I'm afraid where this is going to go.
And he said, they lost an engine. Now the engine didn't actually fall off the plane, but the propeller ceased rotating. So they were losing altitude. And the pilot sent back word, I'm sorry to tell you that we are losing altitude, and if someone will jump into the ocean, it may lighten the load so we can make it to land. Frenchman went to the door and said, Vive la France, and bailed out. An American went to the door and said, God bless America, and he bailed out. And the Englishman went to the door and said, there'll always be an England, and kicked out the Irishman.